Good morning, afternoon, or evening, wherever you are. Thank you for allowing us to be part of this ASR presentation. Today, I will be talking about refining rodent vascular access. I've been, with Instech. I'm sure a lot of you know me. It's really awkward to sort of be here in front of the camera. I really wish I could see all your faces and we can connect the way we normally do. But those of you who don't know me, my intro is I've been at Instech for 10 years and I have an in vivo background. Instech Laboratories has been around for 50 years and we are the leader of suppliers of infusion and blood sampling products. So we'll get started. So I want to talk about improvements in rodent catheterizations. So 10 years ago, typical patency would take us out 2 to 3 weeks. And to be honest, that would be, pretty good in my day. And, as of today, we are out 2 to 3 months and further in many cases. So some of the benefits would be, of course, patency, bi-directional patency. That's the other thing that we always want to cover when we're talking about, how does my catheter work? So ease of use is another thing. I'm sure you guys all remember the days of, plugs and pins and hemostats, and they drop on the floor. I say this all the time in my presentations, but now it's become very, very simple. And then group housing. Group housing is a really cool one. I think more and more of us are recognizing the benefits of socializing animals, giving them enrichment, and really, really, really taking care, even in the small models out there, taking care of their well-being. So yeah, these are the things. So today, now we have typical patency would be out 2 to 3 months. It's simple, and we are able to group house even though they have a cannulation. You can buy a cap and provide them with socialization, which is really neat. Improvements in rodent blood sampling. So I'm sure we all know the traditional ways of taking blood, not only tail vein. I'm sure, and I hope that you guys can feel the pain of this image. There's also sublingual, there's retroorbit bleeds, there's tail nicks. These are all, although they are approved and people are proficient at accomplishing them, vascular access button is a product that's available out there for us to basically stop pain. And it's something we're super proud of because it will work through the access of a port. So it's a lot like large animal VAPs. Ours is the vascular access button. And so it is a closed system. And so this technology allows us to consider some refinements, and where they make sense, they're available. So a shift in equipment. I like this because my products are in there too. This slide shows a little bit of the evolution, the jackets, tail cuffs, harness, that's an Instech product, even pin ports. Pin ports are right there. Pin ports are phasing out as well. We see them, buttons, capillary blood, capillary tubes, all these products are shifting into the VAB. The VAB offers so many refinements, so many benefits, not only to the end user, but also to the length of, data that you're able to get. In some cases you can reuse the animal, and of course also available for mice. So these products are now sort of taking over a lot of our legacy products is what I like to call them. But they're still approved. So it's just that we are seeing a shift even in our pin ports. So that sometimes is surprising, but good. Here's a little video. I always like to play this. This is how the vascular access button is used. This is me in the video. And these guys get to hang out together. And they will exhibit normal behaviors. They will groom, they will lean up against each other. And these are a couple ways that you can access the button. So of course, just direct. It's very easy. You don't need to put them in a holder or anything like that to keep them from running away from you. It's so easy. And poking that port, I know it's silly to say, but it does come up often. Poking the port does not mean you're poking the animal and inflicting any kind of stress or pain. You're just simply poking the port. And the port, of course, is through a cannulation and appropriate surgery. And this is the tether connection. There is a magnet, and you just pop it on. And now you can have access to the vessel without ever even picking up this animal, which is really, that's part of the beauty, is being able to work on top of the cage and not sort of go back and forth inside to handle the animal. So obviously this is just to show you guys some publications. I'm all about facts and data and really looking at the scientific background regarding stress and hormone stress, what we're doing to our animals. You can see here, it's kind of hard to read, but VABs, we started working with VABs in September of 2011 with J&J. We're looking for a better way to access vessels for the habit-forming studies. And so our technology goes way back, and the rest are all just supporting posters and publications and awards and many ways. There's some, all these are available. We have some resources at the end of this that you'll be able to see. But in the end, I love data. I love looking at data. That way we can choose what works best for our studies. And more importantly, for our animals. Like, I want us to continue to find ways to make them comfortable. And I'm positive we will get better data, more repeatable data. It's a huge passion of ours. So here's a little story. This is a couple of VAB studies in mice. The traditional way, so I want you guys to just look at this blue line here. This bottom line here is post-day surgeries, and the top is patency. Patency means, can I take blood from the animal, right? That's the bottom line. So in traditional methods of cannulated animals, I'm talking about everything that was on the left-hand side of our products, right? All of them are included, even harnesses. Patency sort of drops off here after, what is that, 18 days, right? With the VAB, we're able, with a mouse, so these vessels are super duper duper tiny. So with the VAB in mouse for this study, and again, it's all gonna be available, it went out 45 days. 45 days for mouse patency is unbelievable. So that's really cool. And again, not having to do a retro orbit, not having to, you know, poke them in any way, just accessing the button. Here's another one, super cool. For this study, bidirectional patency, rats, reg dollies, these animals went out with 95% patency for 148 days. That is 5 months of patency, right about 5 months of patency. Again, refining the methods that you have going forward by considering the button is really where it's at. That's really where it's at. There's no, the button will land you just with so many other refinements. And I'll talk about other ways that, you know, I think our customers are challenging the product. Now, with all this cool data, right? Let's talk about transparency. I love being honest, and I love saying, okay, so what happens when it doesn't work? Well, let's talk about that. Troubleshooting with VAB problems. What's gonna happen? So really, four things are gonna happen. You're gonna lose patency, it's gonna become infected, or there's gonna be catheter disconnections. So I'll talk more about, but for the most part, each one, so loss of patency. How can that happen? I'm not gonna go through every one here. I think there's many different factors that will attribute to why is my, you know, line no longer working. And so we've also seen seromas and fluid and pocket. How did that happen? What happened there? That comes up all the time. Something we did also, we hear often, is catheter disconnection. I can't stress to you guys enough. The bottom line here is to make sure that you are getting the appropriate inner diameter catheters for whatever metal coupler you have. We have done blogs, we've tested the barb system, we've looked into many other ways of how to prevent a disconnection. And I'll just reference the blog and you guys can see that. We even have videos to show you the difference on how, you know, a catheter becomes disconnected with pull method and PSI. So the pressure that builds up in that. I'm just gonna move on. So I'm getting down to the end here, but I definitely wanted to stress to you guys that some of the refinements are just, to me, they should be just non-negotiable. Less pain to our animals, that's a check in my book. Less stress by handling. Rodents do not like to be handled. They are nocturnal, and they do like group housing. You're gonna use fewer animals, and then you can reuse, depending on, you know, the reuse of animals due to extended patency. Now we're even seeing really cool stuff happen with gestation studies, oncology, where they're implanting the button first and then taking blood time points based on where the tumors have grown. We're seeing mating studies come out. You're gonna see different models. In the end, it's something we're super proud of, and we're super thankful for everyone to come out and listen to this, you know, I don't even know what it's called. This poster presentation. I miss you guys, and I hope that we can see each other soon. This is my next slide. Thank you so much. I miss you guys. God bless, and take care of each other.